Jiu-Jitsu is very complex, or at least that is what we always have been told. As a beginner, it might look almost impossible to learn and collect all the different techniques that are out there. And in fact, I agree. If you focus on collecting all the techniques, it will take you a lifetime to just that. And then it will take you another two or three lifetimes to actually master everything. If indeed such a thing is even possible. My goal with this seminar, which I gave at the BJJ Globetrotters Camp in Heidelberg, was to reduce some of the complexity for you as a student or as a teacher. Reducing complexity can be done by focusing on the recurring patterns that run through human motion, and in this case, through Jiu-Jitsu specifically. There are different patterns that always occur. My focus for this video was to focus on the core motions. These core motions, so the motions we make with our upper body and our hips, are always recurring in every single technique. And by focusing on those, you can greatly improve your skill as a student, your ability to learn, and also ultimately as a teacher. I hope that a good understanding of what I'm about to show you in this video will also help you to reduce that complexity, make you a better grappler and teacher, and I hope you like what I have to show you. Please let me know in the comments what you think about it. Enjoy. So the class is called Core Motions, the Main Threat of Jiu-Jitsu. So I can go two ways in this. I can go very deep into one subject and show all the core motions from there, or I can show you how it's a general thing. And I will still decide how the class goes, depending on how you guys react. So if I ask this question, is Jiu-Jitsu complicated, yes or no? Would you say yes, or would you say no? Huh?
Yeah.
Is it very complex? Well, yes it is, but only as complex, not as complex as you might think. If you think about Jiu-Jitsu in a way that if you think every separate technique is a separate thing, then it becomes like impossible to learn everything. Yeah, because it's like, okay, you have armbar, you have triangle, you have sweeps, you have this, you have that, and like an unlimited amount of connections between two people. And if you really try to define Jiu-Jitsu like that, then it becomes almost impossible to learn. I always compare Jiu-Jitsu to chess. And in chess, I read something cool, have Shannon's number. Ever heard about? Long story short, it means there is more possible chess games than there is atoms in the visible universe. So like more possible chess games than there is sand grains in the desert. Now imagine chess is just 16 pieces on each side with very limited motions. And those games that are possible are like more than the visible universe. That's insane. And in Jiu-Jitsu, we have arguably more possible pieces, our arms, our legs, our head, our core, all those things. And then it becomes like unlimited amount of complexity. Yeah? But like, just like in chess, you cannot learn chess as a whole. It's impossible, but you can learn certain patterns. And what today I want to focus on, like arms and legs, they can do, well, they can also be defined, but that's not gonna be the class of today. But if you just focus on the core, it's actually very simple. So you think about it, what motions can your core make? If you think about your core, well, I will consider core the whole part between the neck and the hip. And actually also talk about the neck, because about the head and the neck. So let's say the core I decide today is the body without the limbs. And if you think about that, what can the core do? You can fold, see? You can hip extend. You can hinge. No, not hinge. You call I will call this actually lateral motion, which you use your obliques. And you can rotate. And every single technique you make, you're going to have to decide one, two, three of those, maybe together, maybe separate. So does everybody by now know, for example, the baby bridge? Ever heard about? Yeah, it's my thing I teach, and I hate the name. Because why do I hate the name? Because the moment you name something, it's good, it sticks. People talk about it, it's good. But the problem with names is the moment you give a name to something, people only think it's that. And they actually lose a lot of other things. So like, for example, baby bridge, what would it be? It would be a lateral motion, see? Then it would be hip extension, and it would be a rotation. And they have all those two things at the same time. But the same thing, if I'm sitting up here, I can still do lateral motion, see? I can rotate and I can look over my shoulder without using the extension. Or I could even say an opposite day bridge where you make yourself small and look over your shoulder. And if you only think about the extension part, then you lose all these other elements. Understand what I'm saying? I'm gonna start now with a technique from X-Guard, just to show you something, how the core motions apply. Can you please come, Francesco? So look. It's not about the X guard itself, but it's just something that I want to show you, like, I have to be aware
of those things about my core motions in reference to his core motions. So if I'm here, for example, and Francisco is standing up and he's standing in the middle and maybe bend a little bit, yeah, and that's it. This is, for me, the worst sport to start from. Well, not positional-wise, but his core right now doesn't give me any clue of what I should be doing. Because what can Francesco do? He can extend his hip, could he stand up, more, yeah. He could be doing this, he could fold over, great. And he can combine those two with lateral motion, so he's made that, yeah. And then, so rotate, so no, stay here, bend forward, see? And then move your body laterally, yeah. And he can move it towards me. And he can also just stand up, for example, and make a rotation on either side. And all my techniques, everything I do in every position is always this. How can I immediately get connection to him, get stuck? And then afterwards, just identifying which motions he can make, how can I stop his motions, or how can I use them to my advantage? So there's basically two simple techniques from X-Guard. And I'm going to show without thinking about Francesco right now. So the first one could be I push him away, see? I start to get up, post my foot, the technical stand up, and he goes down. Great. And the second one you usually learn is put the foot in the hip, put the other foot next to his foot, and then flip him sideways. And I could go on top. And it could also go to the back, and you can do leg extension. Let's keep it very simple like this. Okay? So now, why do your techniques sometimes work and sometimes they don't? It cannot be a random thing. You have to think about it. So usually when I'm here, what I do, I start it. I will raise my head and engage my back. See? And get tension on my feet. See, right now, what is my first test is to test my structure, like Francesco. Like, without too much effort, try to break my structure. So, for example, if you push it in, yeah, push my knee down, it's very bad structure. Okay, now I'm going to do the same thing. Elbow on the floor, look up, engage my back, put some pressure on my feet, and I'll try to break it. Okay, good. And now I'm going to think about my core motion. So will it be initially, I'm going to make like a lateral motion with my head, so you walk away slightly, see? And now from here, I'm gonna look over my shoulder, gonna rotate my legs a little bit, see? Make an extension and start to rotate. And we get over here. And right now the thing that puts Francesco down is my, so if I'm here, push back, I won't go down, go back. But if I look sideways and rotate in, put pressure on my shoulder, see, right now try to push me down, Francesco, it's very hard, right? If Francesco would walk away, see? I could very easily follow with my rotation. And should he push back, I can resist. He comes up, go up, drop my foot. Now the sweep itself would be lateral motion to the other side, look away, put pressure on my feet, rotate in, and go up on that side. Now, next thing, a very big clue in this. So I'm going to give more examples for more positions. If I'm here and Francesco put his weight away from me over there, see, like that, I'm always going to move my head away from his head. And then from here, because he's going away, I will rotate in. So you try to push the pressure back now. Hard, right? Every time he tries to come here and put his weight on that side, see, I'm going to start bringing my shoulders to the other side. Your weight is there. I'll bring my shoulders to that side. If his weight goes there, I'll bring my shoulders to the other side. He goes back in, I'll go to that side. And the legs and arms are just meant as connections. Got this so far? Play with this, and I'll give more examples from close guard. Okay, so let's try. Go. People having trouble even putting the feet correct in the X guard. So I'm going to stop and start doing it with close guard. Because it's not my... The thing is, I don't want to be teaching an X guard class. I don't want to be teaching if you have to put your feet and your hands right now there, because it's a very conceptual class. So I'm going to skip the X guard. The X guard, yes. If you have any questions about that specifically, you can ask me by the end of the class, and we'll gladly fix it for you. But right now, I don't want to go around and start putting people's feet in the correct spots. And you have to know what is an X guard for this class. But I'm pleased here. So we're going to start doing close guard. It's exactly the same thing, and probably even a better position to explain it from. And you're going to see more on that side, but it can be wherever you like. So sit down, please. Hold on a second. Yeah. Thank you. So look, what we have to do, I always think about myself, my core relates to Francesco's core. So every time I fight, I have to think about those three things. Am I going to move laterally to the right? To the left? Am I going to flex my hip or my core? Am I going to extend? And I'm going to rotate. And you know what I didn't mention? I didn't mention a single hip escape. So every time you have to be here, imagine this. Every time in close guard, you escape your hip, you get a huge amount of space which I sit and use to fill up or use that space to his advantage. So what am I going to do? Look here. The first thing I'm going to do in close guard, see, is what is the goal of close guard? Well, the first goal is to keep it, of course, and he wants to get out. And he has two ways to get out. He can go forward and stack and hug and we'll start walking over. Walk over until my feet start to open. Or he can start blocking my hip, walking away with his feet, and open my feet. This is usually the common way of people like to do it. So look, and what often people do, like the beginner, the most fundamental way to open is would be to get up and get away and open this space. And what we do as the person on bottom, when he tries to get away, often reaction is to try to pull the person close. Yes or no? But now we're fighting power with power. He wants to go away and I'm going to try to pull him in. And everything's just about closing this gap over here. So usually the first thing I do when I'm in close guard, first things first, is pull my heels to my butt. See? And now it's just the core. Head on the floor. I'm going to walk my hip up as high as I can. And I'm going to walk closer. Like this. Now look, another trick. You know those people who grind their elbows in your thighs to open it? See? Now look, it only hurts. Think about this. If he's pushing his elbow in my thigh, okay, that's a bit of a little more. It's kind of like a deep tissue massage, but you might say it's uncomfortable. Eh? But if he pushes, and I'm going to push back, he's going to be better or worse? Worse, right? If he's putting pressure, and I'm trying to pull it in, how it starts to hurt. Yeah, so I hurt myself. And what I try to do, I try to walk as close as possible and put my hip up. So I close this space. Now push as hard as you can, please. And I open my knees for him. Push it, please. Push. Yeah, it's like slightly uncomfortable, but some people charge 50 euros an hour for that. So don't worry about that. And try to open it, please, Francisco. Not too easy, right? Not impossible. But if it would open, for example, you're still okay for the head. It's not like impossible to open. This is what you try to do. So you can try this now. Feel a little bit placed here and try to pull and feel how your feet get tired and he starts to walk away. Put the hip inside your butt, it's moving away and my legs will open or tire out. See? And also try this and I'll push my knee, please, with your elbow or with your arm. Yeah. It's tiring as well. And then feel the difference with first heels to the butt, curl your toes, head on the floor, look away, elbows on the floor, and I'll start walking the hip very close. And open your thighs. I'll do the same thing again. Much different. Okay? So we're gonna do this for like 2-3 minutes. Rest it. Feel the difference, and then we go to the next part of the core motion. Okay, let's try. Did everybody feel it works, yes or no? Feel the difference? Does anyone want to help me? I need 2 volunteers to show something. Please, this is awkward. Give me 2 people. Okay, good. Come here. Let's go. 2 of you. Okay, and you can be on top. You're going to be on bottom. Okay, so put yourself. Sorry? No, it's fine. You're going to test something. Sit down, please. You're be in your guard. Go for it. You're going to be in close guard. Yes, you do the exact same thing. So walk closer. Close across your feet. Okay, good. And I'll walk closer. Okay. Now look at this. As you're going to say fight, you're going to fight, and then when I say freeze, you stop moving. Mm-hmm. Okay, so get your teleproper posture, please. Just stay there, don't move. Okay? And you just stay where you are, you start fighting. Go. Okay, go back. Now try not to lose your posture, please. Okay? No, just don't be nice. That's even more annoying. I have to still think about that a bit, but just be there, see? And be very annoying. Just do not break posture.
Okay.
And you're going to try to break his spot and go fight. It's annoying, right?
Mm.
It's impossible almost because his posture is ideal at that moment. Now let's give another example. If you're going to go close with your hip, okay? Cross your legs and freeze, okay? And now you start fighting. And stop. Okay, go back, please. Look what happened in the first fraction of the fight, okay? Fight. Stop. Go back one step, one more time, and yeah, super slow, and stop. Before that. So the first thing you did was move your body out of the center, mm-hmm. Yes? And this kick even by with backward and forward motion. So stop, Francisco, here please. So it's fine, yeah. Let's go. And I will show, look. So look, what happens? If we are here, see, and what I do, you have to think about that. When is the last time you were in this position like this? When you fight Jiu Jitsu, you're rarely, if ever, going to find yourself in a position like that, super symmetric. It only happens when you say, hey, let's do positional rolling, 3-1 fight. Usually when I enter close guard, it'll already be like slightly of the center. But it's a good way as a point of reference to start. So look, when I'm here, see, Francesco, try to stand up straight without moving your core left, right, forward, backwards. Doesn't work, right? Nope. So the first thing he's going to do is always going to like, right now I had knee injury, like surgery, like meniscus. And most people, after a while of repping, they will get more uncomfortable. Do you have knees feel great at this moment? Yeah, for me, it's uncomfortable to be there. But look, start moving, please, fight, stop. You're always, you're usually going to see this motion. You're going to either move to one side or at the very least, put their core a bit forward and start walking backwards. So you're always going to leave the center. If Francesco stays there, then I'm going to try to pull him close. Be tight, okay? Mm-hmm. I'm going to be here. It's very hard. And I make my legs super tired. But if I start to walk forward, see, and I wait now, see, and we can take the hands out of the equation for 1 second, okay? I'm going to talk more about that. If I'm here forward, see, and he makes his first action, go a bit slightly forward, please. Freeze. No, just in the middle. Let's talk about this action first. So freeze. The moment he moves a little bit forward, see? That's when I like to put my hip on the floor, see? Control his knees. And I'll just pull, instead of pulling him down, just pull with the knees forward, like that. And then the hands will post. Maybe he gives you a headbutt if you're unlucky. His hands can be on different sides. That's not the point right now. Before we do this, I want you to test one thing and then go there back. I want you to open your arms as far as possible. Just fly like this. Yeah. And don't use your arms, okay? And you're gonna lay here and you're gonna move yourself up without using your hands. Move yourself up, you can do this. Yeah. Just use your core. Okay. And go back. See? Now go up again. Go up. Great. Yeah? Now go back. So now I'm gonna pull my knees forward and do the same thing.
No.
Now you cannot do that, right? Now use your hands. I cannot stop it. But if I go back, if I use my hands as well, now do it. At least I can stick to him. So what this learned teaches is this. If I just use my arms and not my hips, you can use your arms, push yourself away. It's going to be hard to keep him close. But it's my core fighting his core and my arms fighting his arms. So spread your wings out again here. Just pull your knees forward and keep them. And now go up without arms. Doesn't work. And push up with your arms. Easy. Go back down. Now I grab, pull my arms in, engage my back and pull my knees forward. Now go up. Maybe he goes up, but I will be able to stick to him. That's the same thing with a bend back. I'll go up. And you can push me away now with your arms. I put your hands on my chest. Understand the difference? So I grab, be tight, knees forward, and then engage my back. And then after this, you test your close. Sit here, please. You wait. Go as close as possible. You can keep walking. Fight. So you go forward, you do the lateral motion in a second, because it's usually going to be that. If he goes a bit forward, freeze. You're going to put your hands on his knees and just put your butt on the floor and then pull forward. And the hands will fall, okay? And then the next part, we start about the lateral motion, okay? Try, go. So look, I will do my best to wrap this class entirely up, but I can teach about this for 10 hours. So I'm going to give ideas. And again, try to look further than the close guard. It's just about teaching you the mechanics. So the question here, Wim, what do you mean about engaging the back and why is it important? Well, Francesco, please come in. And I'm going to show it with an example from a leg lock, with a choke, and then from the position we just did. Lay down, please, here. And these I realized like a month ago, and it really changed everything for me. So look, you have three states. You can be the relaxed state, you have the engaged state, and you can move around. Okay, so look. My arm, you're going to relax your leg 100% relaxing, okay? And I'm going to use only my arms alone to give you pain. And it might be enough or not enough. Ready? And just tell me, okay. And maybe it taps, maybe it doesn't. I'm not going to be able to damage anything. But just, okay. Now think about this. Should I make my core round or should I make my core engaged?
Engaged.
Initially?
First round.
Yes, good job. Look, look, if I'm doing this, I'm like a T-Rex. I cannot really grip very far, but if I make my back round, I can go get things, right? So to collect something, you want to have a very round back, and now you can get your hands very high. And I can put some pressure, and maybe that will be enough. At least it's slightly uncomfortable, but you're not going to be dying about it, you know? Then the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to engage my back. Remember, so feel this now, okay? Ah, now it's pain. Good. But what's the problem right now? Usually people do this. They keep their arms tight, they engage their back, and the hands start to come down. So the goal is always this. The first part of submission is always arms, 100% the arms, as tight as possible. I'm not tiring myself out, but I squeeze. Now, my engaged state of my arms beats this, relaxed state. Now engage your foot, and now you feel no pain anymore. My arms are not enough. But when I engage my back, now it's enough. Then the third factor is the rotation. So if I'm here tight, and I put my back in, and now Francesco, you point your toes over there, and it will be still be pain, but I don't think you will ever tap for this in a competition. No? And the same thing goes to the other side. So it's three phases on the lock, right? If I'm going high, I squeeze as hard as I can, and then I engage my back, and now Francesco starts to rotate, I have to think about this rotation, go back. And I can do two things with the rotation. He rotates, I can follow his rotation, I hope what happens. Keep going. And maybe I finish him, maybe he keeps spinning. And he can go to that side, and I can follow his rotation. And again, maybe I finish him on the way because I keep the pressure up. Or maybe goes out of the mat. Oh, 2 points, but not enough. There is no points in reality. And if it's self-defense, you're on the street, threat goes over you. So you don't want to be moving around too much. So the next thing we can do, squeeze, engage. See, great. He moves that side. I'm going to counter his rotation. I'm going to counter his rotation. So he looks away, I'm looking away. Try to move. It's hard, right?
Yep.
And at the same time, if two things bump into each other, the pressure increases. It's not enough to destroy it, but it goes sideways, but it increases. And then if he switches rotation, that's when I get a finish. You have to be patient about that. That's a footlock example. You can do that. If you want to do an easier example, it's from the back. The choke. So I can use just my arm, and I'm gonna be fully relaxed, and I'm gonna choke just using my biceps alone. And maybe, yes, maybe no, you can maybe just adjust a little bit. There we go. Now, next thing is, so now I'm gonna engage his neck. Go for it. And I will never finish with my arm alone, but if I also put my back inside, goodbye. See? Third phase, see, I'm here, and I go for it, and gonna rotate. Rotate fully. Rotate your body fully. No, don't move me. Just turn slightly in or outside. You can choose which side. Back. So I'm in the middle. I choke him and engage. He goes one side. And now there's no more choke. You can spin in or out. This means if I go first to this side, you can follow me and I will never be able to get a choke. So the same thing applies here. I catch. 100% my arm, engage my back, and if he rotates, I counter rotate. He dies. Other side, I counter rotate. And if he switches the rotation, then I got him, and it's like double the thing. That's submission wise.
This was tight.
Sorry?
This was tight.
Okay, good. Yeah. So, and now from the close guard, see? So we're here, I walk up, see? I'm probably gonna be fan fight, can be here, 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 can be this. A million possibilities, not a million, but like a few. Huh? And imagine I'm here, see? And let's keep the hands out. And he's going to put his move slightly forward, freeze. Put my hands on his knees, butt on the floor, pulling forward. And let's say you follow your hands on the floor. I want to catch him. And then I engage back, I don't get there. So I make a sit up with a bent back and catch him, engage my arms, pull myself up, and then I engage my back. Now push me away, please.
Rotates, okay, good.
And I can just use rotation to stick to him. So pick one of those three. I will give you 5 to 10 minutes, but probably not. But might be. Huh? Try and try one of these examples out. Okay. So catch, pulling, engage, rotate. Okay. Let's go. So the choke itself, I will talk more about it on the Thursday class, because it's about the back effects. Can you please? So now look, when we're here. Every time when I'm on bottom, I'm looking at two things. Is Francisco coming close? Is he going away? Is he going left and right? And then the rotation. But most people are not even aware about the rotation. So we start walking forward. And the hands, let's say, I just grab them right now, but it doesn't really matter that much. It could be another class. Let's say I can slightly put them on the side. Okay? Now from here, Francisco, start moving, please. Freeze. He moves laterally to that side and a bit forward. So let's say we stay in the middle and just put laterally alone. No, just move left. Every time he moves over there, see, I'm gonna move myself away over here. I increase the distance. He goes to that side. I'm going to be moving to that side. Now, let's just think about MMA for a second. Imagine, for instance, a good posture. It's MMA, eh? And you can do whatever you like, but don't do it too hard. And I come up, what would you do right now? Bang in my face, exactly. And at the same time, see, if Francisco's weight is here, and I go here as well, I set myself up for a very good punch. So in self-defense, you want to be far or close. See, if it's far away, let's stay far away. If he wants to be close, we're going to be close. So here, Francisco moves his weight slightly sideways, and I move this side, here. And at this point, if he moves slightly forward, freeze, that's when I'm going to keep looking away and pull him in. And whatever happens, happens. His hands can be here, his hand can be here, and even on both sides. The best scenario for me is if he is on my side. And after, I'm going to teach you how to take a proper back take, and then we're going to use the rotation to come on top. What people often do here, when you're here, they will grab, huh? And it becomes like a scramble of 1, 2, 3, we go, I hip escape, and maybe I get it, maybe I don't. Not always, but that happens often. So I go close, see? I'll be here, I feel, and he starts moving, freeze, he goes sideways, move his shoulders away, pull it in, guide the hands. Then from here, I want to create an attack. Like I said before, my core fights his core, and my arms fight, help fighting his arms. So whenever he's here, I will try to grab his neck, see, get you tight, and I'll first things first, I bend my back, and I pull as hard on my arm as I can. So it helps to be in the gym and to biceps curls. But you should not squeeze so hard you get tired. So feel this. And he will tap because he's not moving around now and because he's not engaging, but you feel the choke, right? Mm-hmm. And of course, if I pull and you engage, see, then it doesn't become a choke. But it has to do that, see? Now, the next thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to open my feet and I'm going to point my toes. And it's the only example in Jiu-Jitsu that I know where I will stretch my hips and my legs at the same time. So that's another discussion. But I'm here. See, I pull my toes and I will pull my hip up, push my hip up as far as I can. See, right now, see, he's trying to get your arm out. He will be able to do it, but it takes a split second, right? So as I'm here, I pull him in. I look at my arms as well, not doing this, but I really like push with my left arm, I push my radius into his neck. This feels different to you than this. Feel?
Yep.
And you can often just even start like that and then turn it. And it also increases the pressure. But now look here. So push it in and then rotate your hands. And the pressure increases. Now, as I'm here, I point my toes, push my hip up. And I want to go to his back. His weight is on that side. So I'm going to look away from him as well. That's the baby bridge. You rotate your toes, your hip stays up. Now, as I'm here, this specific to close guard, if Francisco gets his head out, he can slip up and everything was for nothing. So when I'm here, I'm going to put my arm underneath his the armpit, and I'm going to stretch it out. And this is the hardest part of all. See, I want to get my knee on the floor. But when I just do this, I lose all connection, and he's out. So you can just rotate up, get the elbow out. So as I'm here, so I'm going to be closer again. Yeah. I grab it in, so put my toes up, push my arm underneath his armpit, see, rotate my toes, and I'm not going to pull my, I'm just going to keep rotating, pull my elbow in, until my knee magically slips out. And as we're here, then I'm going to take my next step, and just close. If I'm here, great. If I'm here, a little bit less great, but also great. And now my whole goal is, if I try to get your head out, please. He gets out. Okay. We get, whoop. Might be going for K-guard. That's a very good option. But from here, the game, you're going to play a game from here. You're going to keep engaging, see? You're going to look in or out, use your core. My arm is going to stay here. I'm going to use my core to follow his rotation. If Francisco rotates his shoulder up, well, freeze, yeah? More up, I'm going to go more inside. And this, eventually, if Francesco would fall over that side, see, I would follow up and go to mount. I have to think, why would he fall himself and why he's doing it in the sweep himself? Well, yes. If I cannot even sweep him perfectly, if he's doing the sweep himself, and how are you going to sweep him when he's resisting your sweep? So it's a very good drill to do that. Just, I'm here, see, I go in, Francesco starts to fall. I'm going to try to go, just drop, please, roll. I'm going to keep my rotation following. And that's one side of it. And the other side will be, if I'm doing this, if I still don't want to follow, you're going to lower the shoulder, head, shoulders, knees, and toes. And I'm going to go up. And I can go in and continue, but it's not the point of this class. You got it? Or again? Okay, again. So, you go close, walk up. You magically get the both hands. Or one can also, it doesn't really matter. I go in, we start fighting, fight, go, and freeze. He brings himself out of balance, and they always do. Then from here, move yourself away, guide the arm, hip on the floor, moving forward as you move your shoulders away. See, so lateral motion and bend with the knees, hand in the neck, maybe both. Squeeze the neck, try to go for a choke, which you will never get, but it makes you more comfortable. Then point your toes, push your hip up. Do not drop again, so keep it up as high as you can. Keep looking away over your shoulder. Rotate your toes, put your arm underneath, keep rotating, pull your elbow in. You pull your knee out and you step. This is what you want. Usually you're gonna end up with, put your shoulders up please, you're gonna end up with something like that. The knee, if the knee is in, pull my knee in, you will never get it. You will get his elbow out. So your knee has to be out. And now start rolling it, please, go for it. Can be the back, go back please. You bring your shoulder over, rotate it in. If it goes too far back, it can become arm bars and triangles. If it comes too much forward, it goes more of a back attack. So, labor that part, please. Okay? Go.
If you made it till the very end of this video, congratulations and thanks a lot. Let me know in the comments, as I would like to know how many people and which people actually watch my videos till the very end. I also have an announcement to make. From now on, I will be uploading my privates and my seminars as members-only videos on my YouTube channel for just $2.99 a month. Consider subscribing and support my channel this way, and at the same time, get something nice in return. If you want to support the channel in another way, then also please leave a like, share and subscribe, and comment, as this drives the algorithm and I will get more views from my videos this way. In any case, either way, you'll be supporting my channel. See you in future videos. And as always, leave me any questions. I will always be happy to answer.